Okay, in the world of only two digits, we can still multiply. So let's go ahead and multiply 111010 by 101. And after we finish this, we will check our answer by division. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's say 111010 multiplied by 101. Of course, line up to the right, just like usual. And in fact, when you are doing multiplication, in the world of only zeros and ones, it's so much easier because you don't have to know the usual times table. All you have to know is two things. One is one times anything is just nothing by itself. And the second thing is zero times anything, you just get all zero. That's pretty much it. So when you do one times all that, you pretty much have all that. So let's write down 010111. And next, zero times all this, you pretty much get all zero. But you have to remember that this is in the second place. So be sure to start right here. So zero times all this, you have 0000000, right? Six things right here, six zeros right here. And lastly, we do 1 times all that, and this is the third place, you start right here, so pretty much write this down again. 010111. And of course, you add them up, and now let's see. 0 plus nothing and nothing is still 0. 1 plus 0 plus nothing is still 1. 0 plus 0 plus 0 is still 0. 1 plus 1 is 10. So 10 like this. And then 1 plus 1 is 00, so it's just 10 again, so just be sure you write down 10. 1 plus 1 is 10, but plus another 1 is 11, so you have 11 like this. 1 plus 1 is 10, so let's do 10, and then 1 plus 1 is again 10. So the answer to this is, let's see, let me write it down. 1001 and then 00010, like that. Pretty cool, huh? And I want to see if this is correct or not. Well, I will do this divided by that to see if I can get that or not. So, let's see, I want to do 10010010 divided by 101. I want to see what the answer is. So let's go ahead and do our long division. Put this number inside, 10010010 divided by 101. Well, here we go. Here, when you have three digits, I will say, three things right here, you compare three things right here. But 101 is bigger than 100, so you have to use four things like this. And you see, this right here goes into there at most one time. Once again, when you are doing divisions, it's just as easy as multiplication because the type is either 0 or 1, all right? So you put down 1 and you just put down 1 times all that, which is just going to be 101, and you subtract. Okay, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. This is 0 minus 1, you cannot do it, so you have to borrow. So this becomes 10, 10 minus 1 is 1. So it's just like that. And then you continue. You bring down this 0, but you see 101 goes into 100 one time. So put down 1, because 1 times this is 101. When you subtract, let's see. 0 minus 1 doesn't work, you have to borrow, but this is 0, so you have to borrow, you have to borrow again. So you make this 0, and then make this 10, but you borrow this, so this becomes 1, and this becomes 10. Well, you have to borrow this again, this becomes 1, this becomes 10, so finally you have 10 to work with. 10 minus 1 is 1, and then here you have 1 minus 0, so it's 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, right? And then you bring down this 0, and then you see, I will just have to put down 1, because 1 times this is 101, I can subtract. Okay, 0 minus 1 doesn't work, you borrow, this becomes 0, this becomes 10. 10 minus 1 is 1, and 0 minus 0 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. Good. Now, bring down this 0. Okay, 101 doesn't go into 10, so you put down a 0 right here, and then you can bring down this 1 right here. And you see, 101 goes into 101 exactly one time, so 1 times that is exactly 101, and you subtract, you get 0. And you bring down this 0, you see, 101 goes into 00, of course, 0 times. So, in fact, you are done because the remainder is 0. So, the answer is 111010. How cool is this? How easy is this, right? Well, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. And next, we will get into decimals.